In other words, it could be fatal. pull up a lot of data. And apparently the scientists have already interpreted a bunch of this data. And what NBC said is that NASA says the information from Galileo that we have gathered about Jupiter's atmosphere may force, and I'm quoting now, may force a reevaluation of how the solar system is formed. Boy, that's a very non-trivial thing to say. I wonder how far out the moon is going to go. But the information is not wrong. It may force a reevaluation of how the solar system is formed in the first place. The information is due to be released tomorrow. So, what do you think? What do you think they might have discovered on Jupiter that would lead us away from our present scientific ideas of the formation of the universe? Now, this is a very, very non-trivial thing for them to come out and say something that strong. What do you think they mean? There was no Big Bang. There was no solid mass and void and that explosion. And what do they mean? A more trivial aspect of the formation of the universe? Nothing really trivial about it in a lot of ways. So I don't know. But I think we'll stop there. And I've got some more. I've got the bomb dancing. Get your 2 cents worth in. You're welcome to do
Galileo probe.
Well, that's a pretty strong statement, isn't it? That the information may force a reevaluation of the services. It's very wow.
Yeah, I think, and you know, you mentioned right after that, but it sort of got you to think about God, you know, and you know, that's kind of what it makes you think about too.
Well, you know, yeah, sure, of course. I mean, it certainly, we can't do it, can we? We can't create it. God or something, and I think God, and you know, there's always this kind of argument about creation and how it was done. I see the possibility of God, a supreme being, simply saying more or less, create, and then allowing the process to ensue without being involved in every little tiny detail of the creation, as he was not involved in every little tiny detail. Or is not of our lives at the moment.
Right. I sort of agree that that whole process is a little bit of a mystery and we should try to figure it out.
Yeah, I wonder if we ought to know. I mean, if we will ever, or even if we should know it.
Huh. Well, I think we will. But that, you know, a lot of reason for that is I myself am a Christian and I believe I'll know something.
Oh, well, I think you probably will, yes. Just too bad, won't be too bad. You can't come back to us.
Well, why don't we all go there?
Yeah, all right, well, we will. Thank you very much, except
I'm getting my taxes,
so I think we'll be coming to meet you more. But you know, the God loves them, you got to go to the cravings of the mortal. There are more of them than you can know. And either there are a whole bunch of liars out there. And I know this is going to give plenty of fodder for those who like throwing snowballs at them. But maybe there are some people out there. I mean, I've very serious people who claim they've been here for hundreds of years. Or thousands of cases. And I just somehow it got blood up. And then I began to get attacked. And I'm not sure what to make of it. Either there are very articulate, credible sounding people who absolutely claim to be mortal, or there are some very articulate, credible sounding genital liars after later. But I really do mildly suspect there may be something to it, and there may be some of those out there that don't simply get paid. That too is a fascinating east of the Great Rockies, we're on the air.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, alright.
Great. Get that sucker turned down.
There you go.
Right.
Okay, well I just trying to write down, you know, an order of what I wanted to talk to you about.
Okay.
But you caught me at this. So the jump of the Aussie virus to a different species.
Yes.
And you were talking about how that might go to humans.
Well, it could eventually, or it could go to another host like a mouse. Like the virus went to a mouse.
And that's what I was thinking. Something like to the kangaroo.
And somebody called yesterday and said, well, you know, that doesn't mean it's going to jump a human. No, it doesn't mean it. But in fact, I said, remember that the virus did jump a human.
Right. And also, what was that about the telescope thing? I missed the first part of the show.
No. The Galileo. You remember that probe that went down into Jupiter?
Right.
Okay, it survived 1 hour in Jupiter's atmosphere.
Uh-huh.
And in that hour, it sent back a real bundle of data. And NBC said last night that NASA is
Yeah, I was just wanted to inform you, like to call you about the weather down here. Yesterday, passed out about 50 degrees, about noonish, the temperature fell. And by about 10 o'clock at night, it was about 10 degrees, so I control about 25 below.
Good. What about this?
Still, it's not quite as cold. It's, I would say it's like 10, 15 degrees below.
So, well, I don't know what to say about that, except better thee than me.
Yeah.
Okay. It's been running up to about 65, 70 degrees here today. It's been real hot, I think.
Feeling like really nice.
Anyway, yeah, I know the weather, my friend is great. And the only question we're asking is this a cycle? Did we have a bad winter? In other words, followed by a terrible winter? Is it just sort of a cycle or an aberration or the beginning of a profound change?
I think it's an aberration.
You do, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Not a change.
No.
So next year, the plan is much better.
Yeah. Hopefully. Hopefully.
All right. Well, then, thank you very much. My prediction would be, at least with regard to next year, I think this year is going to be terrible. Bad hurricane season. Next year, it will be even worse. That's fine. East of the Rockies, you're on the air.
Hi, I'm Rick. We're in Indiana.
Hi there.
How you doing?
All right.
How goes the battle with pulling the old proverbial cancerous nail that you've got?
First of all, I'm not sure that quitting after this period of time pulls them out. Maybe it stops the final few from being nailed in.
Yeah, I can relate.
But it's on and off. It's a struggle, I tell you.
I was curious to see what branding we did most of you and after that would be.
But I'm not sure. I don't want to mention branding, but I'll tell you this. I believe they claim to have the lowest car and make it clean of any brand made. A lot of people, you know, sometimes I'll give them one of my cigarettes and they puff on it and they give it back. They say, hey, this is even a cigarette.
Yeah, this is a prediction show. I wanted to give you a prediction about the guy with the orangutan bone marrow.
Oh, what would you have predicted?
I would have predicted that he would have died tonight.
Well,
because
as far as I know, so far he is still alive. Boy, would I ever like to hear from you guys.
Well, you know how it is. Almost every time we have to have a relationship,
that doesn't mean that we cannot make scientific progress.
Well,
but yeah, I do sort of agree with that general assessment. We mess around and then. It's kind of like this thing in Australia where the scientists want to kill the rabbits, right? So they have a little island there and got loose now, killing rabbits all over Australia. Now they keep talking about a jumping host, and it seems like when we mess with Mother Nature, yeah, she comes back and kicks us in the butt.
Yep, I can relate. Well, thanks for the call, and have a good show.
Thank you, and have a good morning. West of the Rockies, you're on the air. Good morning.
I'm John, Mr. Bell.
Hello.
Portland.
Yes.
We did go Portland when Al Gore did come to release for our Senate race.
They're supporting him, yes.
Yeah, I'm right. I'd like to say hello to all my noisy brethren in the Mazuma and the Chechen.
The Mazuma Hadid?
The Mazuma Hadid.
Mazuma Hadid? Not
and the Chechen. Fantasy.
Probably would. After the 12 hours, it's been a lot of crazy, like, magic time.
If it did, it would be a disaster. End quote. What are you all hearing about that down there?
Well, I haven't heard a lot about the news.